I'll take up the back to defend our warlock from backstabs.
Hammer okay. and shield, baby. Here we go.
As you guys walk along, I think it only fair that Thorlin take the next in-game 10 minutes of travel or so to kind of tell the party a little bit about himself.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Before I was doing this.
Thorlin, you will never have heard of his family or probably from, you know, even the mountain that he comes from. But from where he was born, he was kind of a big deal. He served in the army or as a defender, pretty much just all around, you know, grunt, mostly as a cook and a brewmaster.
Yes.
He learned to make beer, and that's what he does for a living now, mostly. Sometimes he'll still be asked to cook because he's really not very bad at it. And but his dwarven ale is fairly well known for, you know, quite a ways around Neverwinter. People ask for his ale, but they don't often get it because he only makes it for a few people. But it's a good way for him to make a living. His story starts basically with him waking up at the end of a battle in which the orcs had completely destroyed everyone in his home village. The whole mountain, as far as he could tell, was dead when he woke up in the mud, barely alive, barely breathing. As you've seen, he likes to get down to one hit point as often as possible. And basically got himself out, cleaned himself up a little bit, made his way to Neverwinter, basically made a living as, you know, making beer, cooking whenever he could, but always dreaming of doing something bigger and something, you know, more exciting. He'd heard stories of treasure and dragons and the myths that people told, but he wanted to see something real and something fun. So that's why he took this job.
As you're walking along, very good, by the way. As you're walking along, since you're in the lead, I would like you to take just a perception check as you're kind of telling your story and looking around and whatnot.
Does he have this advantage for telling a tale? Looking around.
Why would you say that? Whose team are you on?
He's seen me walk along and talk and talk and talk and talk and talk, and he knows that I wander and my eyes close and I don't pay attention. But I don't think I should have disadvantage for that.
Right, same team. Sorry.
That being said, I feel like you rolled under a 5. I don't know.
I haven't rolled yet. I actually hadn't picked the die. I'm thinking I'm going to go with that one. Oh.
Oh no, that's not an ominous.
It's not a 1.
Oh gosh,
it's a 2.
It's a 2.
And the dwarf is back down to 1 hit point.
The dwarf, Thorlin's walking around. He's telling his story, and he gets to the end, and he's right in the middle of a joke that he always ends his stories with. And all of a sudden, the dwarf is just ripped up into the air. By a rope that he didn't see as the snare trap snaps up into the tree.
I'm getting a good picture of a comic in my head right now, so I'm going to write this one down.
Is this still part of the story?
I don't get it.
How is that funny?
Bobby, I would like you to roll a dexterity save to try to avoid this.
Crap, I only get a +2 on dexterity save, so 11.
That's enough.
Yay!
You stepped on just the edge of the snare, so rather than being fully ripped up into the air, you're just kind of tossed aside, but you managed to avoid getting grabbed.
Sweet!
Well, that ruins my drawing, so... Alright, so the dwarf gets halfway launched and lands on the tiefling, correct?
No.
Oh.
Why?
Right.
So,
right, same team, my bad.
You keep, that was close, or, you know, whatever.
And, or whatever.
Do you guys want to keep going? Do you want to stop? What do you want to do?
I'm going to stop for sure.
Yeah. You don't have a choice.
Yeah, you're on the ground right now, buddy. Who's got the best perception? I've got a 3.
I've got a 1.
Lux?
I think I have a 1, 2.
Alright.
I guess I will take up the lead instead and kind of do a quick look around for more traps.
I'm going to be right behind you.
Okay.
You don't see anything else. This looks like a fairly crude goblin snare.
Okay.
But yeah, there's nothing else.
Goblin snares.
Every time. Walking down the street in Neverwinter, goblin snare.
I lost a good hammer one time.
As you determine that there's nothing else there, press on down the trail, this time with Kanto very close to Thorlin. Are you actually trading being in front, or what are you doing?
I'm searching for traps. I'd also like to stealth, if that's all right. So maybe I'll get out a little bit ahead and stealth search, if that's all right.
You don't want to tell your story?
Oh, do I get to tell my story now?
That was what the next part was going to be.
All right, well, that usually means I won't get snared unless you're a jerk face.
Who do you think got snared after telling their story? While telling their story. I didn't even get to the climax, and all of a sudden I was ripped off the trail.
That is the story of your life. Okay, well...
Real fast, what are your passive perceptions? I think, Thorlin, you're an 11, Callisto, yep. 12. Are you a 13, Kanto?
What's a passive perception?
Wisdom plus...
Wisdom bonus plus 10. 10.
So my wisdom bonus is 11?
But I think you get proficiency bonus if you're proficient in perception.
I am, so 13.
Nice.
Does that sound wrong?
Sounds right to me. My normal perception check is a plus 3, and I have a wisdom of 12.
No, I mean, I think it's fine, but...
Okay, I don't know.
All right. Would you like to tell your story while stealthily sneaking along, or do you want to stop, tell your story?
No, I'm not going to stop and be like, well, I come from a town.
No, you should sing it.
Yes, I am going to sing it, actually, so I would like to roll performance. I'm not going to actually sing it, but my character is.
Lame.
That is a 17.
Wait, stealthily sing it?
So, 17 on my performance to tell my story. So, it's more of a strumming talk, you know? So, Kanto's father was a prominent human steadholder of a small town. And, you know, he was the big wig in the town with a very powerful wife as well. But his dad had a slight mistress problem, a elf maiden. And things got busy between the two, and out popped Kanto 9 months later, or whatever the gestation period of an elf is.
Not put together. I'm with you now. I'm
okay.
Good.
Yes. So he became.
I was thinking to myself, elf mistress problems. Psh. Like white people problems.
Psh. Yeah, white people problems. So yeah, he's a human. He had an elf mistress. 9 months later, out pops Kanto, and the problem became is he is now. He was the eldest son now and became the eldest bastard child of this steadholder, and therefore, you know, he was given just treated like crap by his I guess not his real mom, but his dad's wife. And so he spent most of his time apprenticing with an old dwarf craftsman that he'd grown to just like enjoy the man's company because it was the only other non-human in the town after his mom was chased out. So he wasn't really good at his hand was actually crafting, but he found an old lute that the dwarf had learned to play long ago, and the dwarf taught him his ways, and he learned how to play this lute, and he became very proficient with it. And eventually, you know, when he got to of age, he was basically threatened by his dad's wife, that if he didn't leave, that she would track down his real mother and kill her. So he took up his loot and went on the road, and eventually was picked up by a recruitment, like a scout at a tavern when he was playing a song, and he was brought into the college of you know, the Bard College, and, you know, was picked on, and, you know, for being a half breed, but since he was so talented, he often brought on jealousy from the other members. And before he could completely graduate, you know, he was chased out of that as well and decided to make his way to Neverwinter. And that is where he got mugged, and someone stole his loot that the dwarf gave him.
Roll perception for me.
Oh, there it comes. And that is a 18.
Good enough. Woo-hoo. You notice what appears to be some oddly placed sticks and leaves in the path ahead of you.
Hey, Thorlin, you should keep walking. I'll point it out to him and be like, guys, I think we got another trap up here. We should try to skirt around it if we can.
Okay. Are you going to try to trigger the trap, or do you want to go past it?
Oh, I figure we should probably go past it in case, you know, we need to kite some goblins back through and maybe they can trigger it for us.
Can we get the wagon past it without tripping it?
We don't have the wagon with us.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. We're on the trail. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. We're such a great guards, aren't we?
We're just going to be completely looted by the time we get back.
Who are you people?
Gosh dang it.
Now that you have all told your stories and have earned the inspiration you were given and avoided these two goblin traps, would you like to continue on stealthily?
I would for sure, just because I'm proficient in it.
Do you want me to have to roll for stealth?
Before anyone rolls for stealth, you need to decide, is Kanto going ahead, or are you all kind of going together and just hoping that you're stealthy enough?
Well, I think that if Kanto is going to stealth, he should go a bit all by himself.
I'm okay with that.
Without singing.
Just kind of lightly whistling. That's staying in the podcast, by the way.
The whistling or the nose blowing?
The nose blowing.
How did you... This is not the mute switch, is it?
Apparently not.
That's awesome.
You guys seriously hear me right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I will, I apologize. I will start using the other mute button that's not on the microphone. Very careful to mute that and covered the microphone.
Great.
You guys also hear me chewing?
At one point, yes.
I should have warned me.
It would be fun.
I've been muting it during that too, trying to be all pleasant and nice.
So is Kanto now on ahead, or do you have to roll first by yourself?
I don't know.
Make sure that. All right, if Kanto is going on ahead by himself, splitting the party, Kanto can go ahead and roll.
Wait. Not that far ahead. Just enough to kind of be a scout. Okay, yeah, I'll roll. That is a 15.
Okay.
Great.
I think I forgot something back in the cart. Let's go back, Bobby.
You suck. Don't make me vicious mockery, you.
Following the goblin's trail, you come across a large cave in the hillside, about 5 miles from the scene of the ambush. A shallow stream flows out of the cave mouth, which is screened by dense briar thickets. A narrow, dry path leads into the cave on the right side of the stream. You are on the left side. And also all along that's the right side of the stream, the far side, is just dense thicket all the way up until just about at the cave entrance where it seems to thin out a little bit.
So if I move through the thicket, can I get an advantage on stealth if I need to roll again?
Possibly, depending on what the thicket is. It looks pretty dense.
Excellent.
To the point where you can actually have trouble navigating
it. Oh! Slapping my face as I move through. So I don't see anybody at the entrance or anything, just empty, or just a cave mouth?
Yeah, it's just a cave mouth with a stream coming out of it.
Alright. I don't want to risk trying to sneak up there and then being, like, 5 turns away from my team, so...
We can all go up together and just check for traps.
Yeah. So I'll go back and get them and tell them, like, hey, found the cave. Like, I don't see any guards yet. And go in together, I guess?
I'm down.
Cool.
If we have to.
Damn it.
Eldritch Blast. Eldritch Blast.
Waiting for Callisto to be like, you didn't clear it by yourself?
Yeah. What's going on here?
You guys are so boring.
All right. You know, as you are, so you're all going back to the cave together. If you would like to try to maintain stealth, I will need you to roll.
All of us? Excellent. Kanto got an 11.
Calista? Do I have to say it?
Yeah, you have to say it.
Oh, wait, you said Calista first.
The natural one should always be last. Calista?
I'm at a 4.
Jeez.
Oh! My lowest die was a 4, but with my plus 2, I get 6. So I'm not the loudest one.
Aren't you wearing chainmail?
Yep.
All right. Excellent.
I'm not even trying.
Calista's just like filing her nails, smacking gum really loudly. I don't know why Calista is a valley girl in my headspace, but okay.
But her actual voice is Lex's voice.
Yeah. So you guys approach the stream and the cave and the briars, and you're being as stealthy as you can be. What would you like to do?
Check for traps.
Yes, we check for traps.
Okay. I'll just need one of you really to perceive.
I have the highest one, so I guess I'll roll. 17.
All right. As you're looking around, you don't spot any traps. But right as you look towards the thicket, you look up just in time to see two arrows lance out of the dense briars.
Son of
possibly because of the noise. One hits you, and one hits the dwarf.
Oh.
Nice scouting, buddy.
It's a 21 versus Kanto, and a 17 versus... oh, well, do you have your shield out?
I'm carrying my shield and my hammer.
He did say that, yeah.
18. Does not hit you. Yeah, right. Sorry.
Hits my shield.
Down. Thankfully, I have 23 AC.
Yeah. Good on that. That was a strong choice.
Yes.
That option.
Bard armor. 23 armor class.
Bardmer.
I think barding is something else.
Oh,
I think
my
that's not you.
My bad.
I know.
Alright, how many points do I have left?
Alright. Go ahead and roll this.
Oh, this is going to be hurt. This is going to hurt.
That's going to be 6 damage.
Oh, down to 5.
So, Bobby, your friend's going to play like a priest or a paladin, right? Cleric or paladin? Seems like that'd be useful.
Somebody who can heal someone but themselves.
I do have healing word, actually.
You do, and actually probably want to consider using that at some point.
I can cast 2 spells for the rest of the adventure, so I gotta be careful.
As it's going now, 6 goblins are wrecking you. Granted, this is for 4 people, but still, you know, one hit.
Did you say 6 goblins?
Well, the 4 previously.
Oh, okay. I was like, run!
Goblin archers, the bane of your party. You're going to be level 20, like, walking around, and, like, a goblin's going to take a pot shot and kill someone. You're going to be like, oh, I just cast the spell, and it's super powerful, but it leaves me with 1 HP dead.
yeah!
Okay. That was obviously a surprise round, before you are surprised. Go ahead and roll initiative, please.
Come on, baby. Oh my gosh.
I'm 10. At 7.
5.
17.
Oh, good. Okay. Not all of you are terrible.
just the bard. That guy sucks. He's just constantly in a state of distraction.
Are you singing to yourself again?
Oh, arrow.
So, what you'll need to know is that you can kind of, sort of see 2 goblins on the other side of this thicket row, this thicket hedge thing.
But I thought you said 6.
No, that was including the 4 that we fought earlier.
Oh.
Just a grand total of the goblins. They have half cover from the thicket for ranged attacks. Lex, you rolled a 17, you said?
Yes.
I believe Calista goes first then.
Excellent.
How far away are they?
Let us see. It is 3 spaces, or 3, yeah, 3 spaces to the river, then the head starts in the next space, and it looks to be 2 spaces thick,
30 feet.
30 feet away from you, but you can't go through the hedge. So to get to them, about 8 spaces worth, so 40 feet, because you'll have to go through the river or through the stream and up and around. To get to them by foot, you'll have to go about 40 feet.
What about ranged attack?
I think I said 6, so 30.
30?
Yeah. I'm going to see you guys kind of got into this area a little bit, so maybe a little bit less than that. Maybe 30 feet to run to them, and then maybe still about 25, 30 feet to shoot them.
All right. Well, clear? We're all clear on the situation?
Yep. You're ready to roll.
Yep.
All right.
Kanto's taking a nap.
I'm just going all out again. I'm going to use Hex again on... are they both... I assume they're more or less the same distance away, so I'll just...
they're standing next to each other, yeah.
Yeah, I'll just pick one. Doesn't matter at this point.
Thing one, thing two.
Yeah. And then on the same target, I'll use Eldritch Blast.
Did you just do a Dr. Seuss quote?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, continue.
Right, so to hit is 17.
It's a hit only because they are not using their shields.
Oh, excellent.
All right.
Nice.
I presume that when it says they have leather armor and a shield next to their AC, when they're using something other than the shield, it's minus 2 AC. Yeah. Hopefully we're playing that right. Actually, it's a hit no matter what. A tie works, so...
What ability checks? Is that also for on an ability? Is it also for attack rolls and such?
Just nuke the dude.
It says ability check.
Yeah, the target has disadvantage on ability checks made with the chosen ability.
Oh.
Yeah, that I believe is all attacks as well. If you use Dex, it's all Dex attacks. Strength, right. It's all strength attacks.
Alright, then I'll go with that he has disadvantage on Dex.
Yeah.
Alright, and then for the damage, let's see, that was 1 dice 10, that is 4, and 1 dice 6. 10
and it is 6, I believe.
That's 9 damage.
You kill him.
Nice.
Nice work.
Thank you. And that gives me 5 temporary hit points.
Jeez.
Yep. And you actually do want to track that now, because that's important.
I have those?
No.
Damn. Lux just became the tank. Okay. So, actually, when you get mage armor, you kind of can. It is now, what did Kanto roll?
I believe I rolled a 5, was it?
Alright, if it's less than 11, that's all I care about.
Yeah.
Seeing his buddy Eldritch Blasted down into oblivion, this little guy will take a shot on Callista. He rolls a natural 20.
Oh!
Which is good for him, because I also rolled the damage die at the same time, and it's a roll to 1. But a natural 20 will do max damage of 8.
Ooh. So 8.
Get rid of your 5 temporary first, and then you take another 3 off your real hit points.
All right. Puts me at 7. Yep. Come on, guys. Do I have to do everything by myself?
Yes. I'm going to use Healing Word on myself. If it's my turn.
Yes.
All right. That's a 1d4 plus 4 health back to myself. Let's see what I get here. Come on. Oh, beautiful. I rolled a 4. So that's 8 hit points back.
Excellent.
And I am back up to max. And can I move behind the dwarf?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll kind of crouch down behind the dwarf.
My turn?
Dwarf.
Can I also give as an extra... I don't know. Can I give as an extra action Bardic Inspiration? Is that how that works?
What is the description?
Oh, I gotta find it now. Crap. Bard. It says... Bardic Inspiration. You can inspire others through stirring words or music. To do so, you use a bonus action on your turn. Okay. And I can do this up to four times. So I'm going to use Bardic Inspiration actually on Lex, since he's going to be the only one that can reach, seems like.
I can throw my hand axe.
How much does it do?
D6.
Lex, then.
Yeah, 3.
So on your turn, Lex, you get an extra D6. And I'll say, go, you beautiful thing, you. You can do it.
A D6 on what?
Added to your attack roll. Or whatever
or
you use.
Else you.
Yeah. Oh,
nice. Thank you.
You have to use it for anything within the next 10 minutes.
Yes, 10 minutes.
Well, thanks. And thanks for the compliment.
Yeah.
Healing word. This is important, though. Healing word. Standard action or bonus action?
I only have one bonus action.
Healing word cast as an action is the question.
Well, Bardic Inspiration isn't a cantrip. It's just a...
Doesn't matter. You only casting, have this action.
Casting time is one bonus action.
Therefore, you cannot use both, is my point.
Oh, balls. Well, I will not use Bardic Inspiration.
I'm pretty sure in 5th edition you cannot trade a standard action for bonus action.
I did not realize Healing Word was a bonus action. Therefore, I take back my compliment.
Worst cheerleader ever.
Now it's no longer worth it to have that, and you want to go with... a standard action healing spell instead of healing word?
No, just because I like the idea of being able to insult someone while healing myself or someone
else.
So
but that's why we went with that, was because it was a bonus action and not a full action.
I completely forgot. Sorry, Lex. So no extra D6 for you. That was a waste of breath. So for my standard action, can I just plug this dude with a crossbow then?
Yep.
I will do that.
Nice.
That
and
is
and of course shot, you can all... Headshot.
So I gotta make sure I'm doing this right. So for my crossbow, my attack bonus would be my dex plus my proficiency, because I'm proficient in crossbows.
Yes.
So it would be 5.
Your dex plus 2. Yeah. All attacks you make dexterity wise, because you're not using a non proficient weapon, are always gonna be plus 5.
Okay, I'm using a proficient weapon, so plus 5 would be 20 to hit.
Woo.
Alright.
Excellent, and my damage is D8 plus 3. That is, balls, a 6 total.
Close.
Yeah, I know. So, hit him with your hammer.
Well, he's more than 25 feet away, right?
I will say from you, he is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. I would say he's 5 from you.
So 25 feet?
Yeah, because I originally was counting your space as the 6th space. Oh, so yeah, you can hit with a 25.
Speed covers it. So I'm gonna drop my shield and take my warhammer up two-handed and smack him in the head again.
You only need to do one damage.
I know. That's why I want to roll a 20 on it.
Guys, this is important. You are not 25 feet running from him. You are. I thought you were asking the distance for throwing to him.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
There's a wall away. Yeah.
So 25 feet. So that'll put him into long range, because the range on my hand axes is 20-60.
Oh, okay. See, I was thinking the 25. But you can step up, throw, and be in short range.
Yeah, you can move and throw.
Can I throw them both? I have 2 weapon fighting, but all that really gives me is my proficiency bonus on the damage roll for the second attack.
Are they light weapons?
They are, where is it? Light, comma, thrown, range 20-60.
Yes, I'm quite certain you can.
Woohoo! So I can throw them both at him.
Dude, that's awesome.
And just, both get your strength bonus, yes.
Just in case. I'm going to roll them both at the same time.
I'm pretty sure. I think you're going to kill the first one, but I'll check.
But it might miss, so I'm going to roll them both.
He just wants to roll both dice.
He just loses his hammers in the stream.
I rolled a 10 and a 15.
The 15 will hit because he does not have a shield out.
Woohoo!
Good thing you rolled both of those.
And that's D6.
I think you just need a 1, so don't suck this.
4.
Nice.
Your hammer smashes into his face and he drops down behind the thicket.
I like when they drop down behind the thicket.
I think it was an axe.
But... It was, hand axes.
Oh, I thought you said hammer. I'm sorry.
No, I can't.
The hammer I can't throw. My hand axes I can throw.
I thought you had just all hammers, all hammers all the time.
I'll go with throwing hammers if that's what you want.
You can do that. Although it is nice to have, you know, different types of damage if you want.
Well, it's slashing versus bludgeoning.
Exactly.
Okay, I'll stick with slashing. You never know.
Better make sure he's dead.
Go I gotta over. Retrieve my hand axes.
Okay, so here's what it says. If either weapon has the thrown property, you can throw the weapon instead of making a melee attack with it. So, to all effects and purposes, seems as though you can make two thrown attacks.
So I really did 6 damage because I still get my proficiency bonus on the second attack?
Well, yeah.
First one missed, second one... Well, but on the second attack, unless you have two weapon fighting, you're not supposed to get your proficiency bonus on the damage roll.
No, you never get your proficiency bonus on a damage roll. You
except on the two-weapon fighting, don't I get it on the second damage roll? Isn't that what the whole two-weapon fighting thing is about?
You get your ability modifier.
Oh, not proficiency. Ah.
Proficiency is never added to damage unless specifically stated. So for two-weapon fighting, if you were fighting with two weapons normally and you didn't have a bonus to it, you would only add your strength bonus to the first weapon.
Right.
Second one would just be a roll. But instead, you add it to both of them. Which is
I mean, it doesn't really matter. I still did 4 damage, but I would kind of like to do 6, even if I only needed to do 1.
Yeah.
I'd kind of like the head to pop up and off and squirt a little blood before he fell into the thicket.
You are now out of initiative. And because you have found this cave and made it past the 2 traps and the 4 goblins at the ambush site and the 2 goblins here... You have 75 experience points.
Booyah! Yeah, how much do we need to level up?
300?
200? That's not bad.
300.
Oh, 300. That's it's much better than freaking, what was that, Advanced Dungeons & Dragons, where you need like 2,000 as a fighter, and...
Yeah.
Anyways.
Dungeons & Dragons used to be pretty fucked up. Okay, alright, so you are... Now at the stream, Thorlin crosses the stream in order to go get his...
Hey, can Thorlin use his bonus action to heal after that?
Oh, yeah. I threw my axes, actually.
I would have let him use it,
retroactively
in front. You do not have any hit dice left to spend, though.
Oh, because he spent it during his rest?
Unless it's just another one on top of that for free.
Let me look and see if it is a hit die. I thought it was just a D10, but I will double check.
Okay. While he's looking that up, he goes around the edge of the thicket and realizes that there's an entrance into a little area, and this is what he sees. On the east side of the stream, flowing from the cave mouth, a small area in the briar thicket has been hollowed out to form a lookout post or blind. Wooden planks flatten the briars and provide room for... guards to lie hidden and watch the area, including the now-dead pair of goblins that were lurking there.
Hmm. Nice. Here's the text for Second Wind. Limited well of stamina you can draw on to protect yourself from harm. On your turn, you can use a bonus action to regain hit points equal to 1d10 plus your fighter level. Once you use this feature, you must finish a short or long rest before you can use it again.
Oh, you can get it on a rest.
Yeah.
I will let you retroactively, since there's only 3 of you, use it for the first fight, and then use it for the second fight.
You're awesome. So I will use it now.
So we'll presume you went back up to full health after the first fight, which would put you at...
I'd still be at full health, because the second fight, it hit my shield.
Yeah, he's really at full health then.
You want me to roll? It's D10 plus 1.
Roll the 1 for the first battle.
Oh, I rolled a 2.
So you do need it.
So I take 3.
So, okay.
So that makes me 11, which is almost full.
Yeah.
So you might want to save it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't mind another short rest.
You think I should save it?
Yeah, I would save it in case you
get... Yeah, we can rest, huh?
You can if you feel safe sitting for an hour outside the cave. Where you just kill 2 goblins.
With the tiefling on guard, I do.
I want to rest, too. I'm the one at 7 hit points here.
Can I check out the guard post for any goodies first?
You can roll, yeah.
That is a 15 for perception.
You unfortunately don't find anything of value.
Okay, fair enough. I guess I'll, since I'm full and everything, I'll stay on guard while we rest or whatever, if that helps.
Can you use that healing word also outside of combat?
Yeah, but I don't want to. I only have one spell left.
Do we need a short rest or a long rest? Because if we can take both, you stand guard for a while, then I'll stand guard for a while, and we'll see how healthy we can get.
I have a pretty good
feeling. Long rest is 8 hours, and I have a feeling that you guys have the feeling that there's very little chance that nothing comes out of that cave.
Which is why we leave one person awake and on guard at all times, but we could sleep for a while.
Yeah, but you waste the entire rest if you get interrupted.
Son of a...
If you get interrupted at 7 hours, you wasted the entire...
And we left the wagon how far back?
5 miles.
I say we risk a short rest and just go with that.
All right. Can I get hit points back at a short rest?
You may spend one hit die.
I spent my hit die last short rest.
Yes, you did.
I'll do it now then.
So I can stand guard while you guys rest.
I don't need to. I'm good.
We'll stand guard while she rests.
Maybe retroactively you could use, just to get back up to full health, your one surge or whatever it's called. But I'm going to say, because you guys didn't necessarily know in that battle that you were going to rest right here, that you didn't use it. And I don't think you can use that one outside of combat.
Yeah, I can't.
Because it's all, you know, like, power-fueled. So I'm going to say that you just kind of lose that one when you get this next one recharged. You know what I mean? So you're still just going to be 2 hit points down.
Okay. So we only have one hit die per long rest. Is that what it is?
Because your first level. That's why second level is such a boost.
Gotcha. That makes sense.
Which means you can go farther.
We've gotten to, like, the beginning of the cave, and we've already had to rest twice. All right.
So I'm going to roll that hit dice.
Remember, this is your only hit die, Lex.
Yeah.
Until we get a good night's sleep.
I don't think that's
I'm down to 7 hit points.
Out of 10, though, right?
Guys, we only need 225 more experience points to get to second level.
Fine.
Think of all the goblins we can kill.
Fine, I won't.
You will not get second level until the end of the session.
Son of a...
Fine, I won't use my my hit dice then. Fine, alright.
How low are you, Lex?
I'm down to 7.
But because you guys have so little, that 7 is enough to almost get one-shotted.
Yeah. You might want to. I mean, if you're going to use it now or later, you might as well get as healthy as you can and be able to take a beating if it comes to it.
He also gets temporary hit dies when he kills stuff.
Oh.
There's no reason why he's at 7 instead of...
Okay, question.
2.
Lex, what's your alignment, can I ask?
My alignment is... I just have it neutral.
So, if I can choose to leave somebody alive by reducing them to 0 hit points instead of actually smashing their head in with my hammer, can I hold them up for Lex to kill to get that bonus?
Rule abuser.
I'm just saying, if I know she gets a boost off of it, can I just knock them out and then stand them up and give them to her and move on to the next one?
I'm going to say no.
Dang it.
Because the wording of that is very specific to when you reduce someone to 0 hit points.
Right. So she would reduce them to -1 or more.
Yes, which is not reducing to 0.
But she would kill them after I kept them alive.
The wording is not to kill them. It is to reduce them to 0.
So they were already at 0.
Also, it's not in the spirit of the rule.
I do like the way you think, though.
It was all about you.
That's just more of a nature. Okay. You manage to rest in this little hollowed-out thicket area without any interruption. You don't hear anything other than the stream. You have a feeling that if anything's inside the cave, the stream probably drowned out the sounds from outside.
This is a short rest, right?
Yeah.
1 hour.
So, Lex, did you decide to use it or not?
No.
All right.
But if I'm dying because of this, I will never stop bitching about it.
Then use it, please, because it is worth it to not hear you. God, you just go on forever.
It is unless you think you're going to get to rest inside the cave, this is the last time you're going to get to use it.
Then go for it.
You can't use it after battle. You have to use it during a rest.
Go for it.
All right, then I'd use it now.
Just hopefully roll a 3, because if you roll that 8, you're going to be sad that you wasted 5 hit points.
I'm at 5. I rolled a 5. Nicely topped off.
All right, there you go.
All right. So I presume you're going to head inside the cave.
Yep. Looking for traps.
Are you also being stealthy?
I can't be stealthy.
Yeah, he really can't.
I mean, I can try. I'll roll for it. I'll totally try to be stealthy.
Use your inspiration to offset that.
So if I'm kind of sneaking off to like the side and he gets spotted, do I get like stealth advantage with combat starts or something like that?
No.
Can I use my inspiration to offset the disadvantage?
If we're talking about a very large distance, I might allow that. If we're talking like you're 5 feet from him, then no.
So I'm kind of I'm curious, how the hell does an assassin like sneak around and with this party just being like clomp 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 clomp?
He goes separately usually. Like we're talking about a barely one square wide path.
Okay. Okay then.
If one of you,
I'll kind of peek
over.
Hang
back. I'll hang back. I mean, I don't want to, but if I know I'm giving you away, I'm not gonna want to give you away.
I do have dark vision. And you I do have a vision. Good stealth.
I have dark vision.
So,
just not
yeah, you all stealth. Have dark vision.
Yeah. I'll do a quick scout.
Oh, you know what I have that will help? Stone cunning.
Yes.
I can tell you a lot about those pavers.
You're going to scout again after what happened last time?
Well, but next maybe. Time I won't tell you anything. And
would it make much of a difference?
Oh
now, would
my
it?
Gosh. Anyways. Can't ignore the tiefling because she's.
You may roll for stealth.
What is my stealth? My stealth is get a plus two, and I have disadvantage, right? Because of my chainmail. Oh.
But if you fail this, you can't be like, oh, I rolled a five, I'll stay back. I mean, you're pushing.
I rolled a six.
Well,
I mean, I rolled a four. My plus two, it's a six.
That totally wasted my 18.
Damn it.
As you enter, just inside the cave mouth,
damn it, Bobby.
Yeah, there you go.
A few uneven stone steps lead up to a small, dark or small, dank chamber on the east side of the passage, which is to your right. Where north is forward. Okay. Convenient. The cave narrows to a steep fissure at the far end, and is filled with the stench of animals. Savage snarls and sounds of rattling chains greet your ears, and you can see three wolves chained up just inside the opening. Each wolf's chain leads to an iron rod driven into the base of a stalagmite.
Hmm.
These wolves are about 10 feet from you.
I'm guessing they've seen us already?
The wolves have, yes.
And are they looking pissed off at us?
They are snarling and snapping their jaws at you, yes.
Are we getting initiative?
They are straining against their chains. You are not in initiative.
I
kill them now before they get free.
You first.
Fine. I'll roll Eldritch Blast at them.